Hey gearheads, and welcome to Garage Talk. I'm Corey, and that is the first ever all-electric Cadillac. That is the 2023 LYRIQ, and that is the extra rare debut edition in rear-wheel drive. And in this video, I'm going to take you on a quick tour of the future of the brand and take you for a short drive. Stay tuned. It's like a spaceship. Before I get too far into this one, I do want to say a huge thank you to my friends at Wagner Cadillac for allowing me time with this ultra rare, one of 1,500 produced LYRIQ debut editions. If you want to make this one yours, I have a link to their website down in the bottom in the description. Let them know GT Garage Talk sent you. But as per usual, I will start under the hood. And I say that a little funny because, well, this being an electric vehicle, there isn't anything really under the hood, actually, because you just get this large plastic panel. You see, there is a removable section here for emergency responders and things like that. But this center panel actually does give way if you pull on it. And you can see the electric motors and battery packs or all the wires and different things down there underneath there. So you can see almost instantaneously why there's hard plastic in here. But unlike some competition looking at you, Mercedes EQS, you can't actually open the hood. There's just really no need to. Even though you can and don't have to, they still put a heat shield under here with the Cadillac crest logo underneath. Closing it, we can look at the new face of the Cadillac brand. So get used to this grille, this lighting treatment, everything about this, because this is the new design direction of the brand, debuting here on this LYRIQ, but also being shown off on their ultra premium $300,000 plus bespoke Celestiq, very large luxurious sedan. But you can see we get these jeweled headlights that I absolutely love. And then the grille can light up and do all these lighting elements on it. Obviously, here in the bright daylight sun, I can't show you all of that, but so I was able to turn the vehicle around and show you a little bit more of the lighting up front here in the grille, just to give you a sense of what the lighting really looks like up front here. So you can see all of this around here lights up and does welcome animations and goodbye animations as you leave and approach the vehicle. So pretty cool here. The lighting, yeah, it's pretty top notch. I absolutely love these jeweled headlights. Down here, down low, it looks very good. It's growing on me. It's not my favorite. There are some things that I wish were a little bit different, but being that you don't have to feed air into a internal combustion engine, there's a lot you can do with this space here. And then you get a new monochromatic look at, thank you, I am near the hospital. So you get a new monochromatic look at the new Cadillac grille. And you can see that looks like it lights up as well. But very clean look up here on the front. And as we move around to the side, very interesting and unique styling as we move to the back, but very familiar crossover styling in the middle. So I'm getting a lot of two different vibes of vehicle with my time in this. So the Mercedes-Benz EQS SUV, very similar in this, although much pricier, a little more luxurious, but at twice the price I would hope that it would be. I'm also getting a lot of Mustang Mach-E vibes in this, and you'll see what I mean here in just a second. But before we move in any closer, I do want to show the tires are 20-inch wheels with 265/50R20-inch Michelin Primacy Tour tires, same type of tire that Hyundai uses on their award-winning Ioniq 5. It's becoming a very ubiquitous tire selection for electric vehicles. I think we're going to see a lot more of these in the future. But coming around here to the back of the vehicle is perhaps the most controversial styling element of it. Again, this is a future design choice direction of the Cadillac brand. It is also featured on that $300,000 Celestiq. And I don't know. It does look better in person. Still growing on me, not quite sure. You know, my first vehicle ever when I was 16 years old, actually when I was 15 years old, was a Cadillac Eldorado. So I've got a lot of stake in this brand just from a personal history standpoint. But I don't know, this design is still growing on me. Let me know in the comments what you think. We do have this LED light running all the way down the side, very large, but you really can't see it too well when you're straight back behind it. It really is a side design element more than it is a rearward design element. Back here at the back, you do get some running lights up here that kind of mimic the Doppler effect. And then down here, you get your actual brake lights that are very reminiscent of like an Escalade, just a little smaller and a little more down low. Very interesting look there on the LYRIQ. And then if you want to get back into the back, you can push the button on the key fob or push the Cadillac crest logo right there, and you get decent cargo space inside here. So we've got up to 60 cubic feet with these seats folded down, which is made very easily from these electric latches. Let's see, there we go. Just gotta hold them a little longer, and the seats do go tumbling forward, making for a lot of room on the inside of this thing. And I can shove my full-size suitcase all the way back and show you exactly what is down underneath the floor storage here. So we get our charging cable, our front license plate bracket, a portable bag for that charging cable, just a little bit of extra storage down here. There is an SD card slot, which is a very interesting place to hide that. But you can see it is also carpeted, so anything you put down there won't rattle around. And then there's even more back behind there, also carpeted, so it's not gonna make a bunch of rattling noises when you get back there. But I'm actually gonna pull that back, push the hatch-mounted button to let that close. And we will talk a little bit about power before we go to the inside. Now, I did mention this is one of the rear drive models. You can get a dual motor all-wheel drive, but this one is a rear drive unit making over 300 horsepower and over 300 pound-feet of torque. More specifically, 340 horsepower and 325 pound-feet of torque. You might have noticed that 450E badge back here on the back right here. That is actually the torque in newton meters, rounded up, because it's 440 newton meters total. Woo, get a nice gust of wind. So powerful, quick, fun, exciting, quiet to drive. We will drive it here in just a little bit, but I do wanna bring you into the window sticker here, because estimated 312 miles of range and sticker price of $60,000. So again, much, much, much more affordable than the Mercedes-Benz EQS SUVs that we've tested here on the channel. Actually kind of close to in line with current Mustang Mach-E prices. So do you want a Ford or do you want a Cadillac? That one's up to you. My money would probably be on Cadillac, just a little more prestige there. If you want to talk about charging, you can access it through that charge port right there. It's a motorized door. There is your J1772, and you can pull that out for DC fast charging. And I already showed you the cable back there in the back for at-home charging. That is everything out here on the outside, but before we hop in, I did want to show you the key, typical Cadillac key here. So we've got lock, unlock, remote start, and your hatch release with a panic, but very typical. More things that give me Mustang Mach-E vibes are the door handles. So I actually get what looks to be a handle on both the front and back doors, but like the Mustang Mach-E, we get this little winglet handle right here. So you push, and then a little motorized leg kicks out and keeps this door propped. I cannot push it, I cannot close it. I just grab it by this handle, and you can see there is the little leg that kicks open to leave the door open, letting you inside. The back door, again, like the Mustang Mach-E, push the button, little leg kicks it out, cannot close it, and you grab right here. There's a nice rubberized panel right here on the back. But we'll get into the back seat in just a second. Let's move inside. Looking at these seats, heated, ventilated, and massaging with speakers in the headrests, Very nice, very comfortable, very luxurious, very soft leather here, and lots of leather around the side because Cadillac moved the controls to the door. So no longer do you need a lot of plastic here on the side. I actually put a lot of seat material. Speaking of those doors, we've got this wood here, wood trim here, little lighting elements on the side, tube style of heat. You could do seat bottom and back or just the back, and ventilation, two-person memory, all your controls here. That's for your massage. Mirror controls, window controls, your actual latch is right there to get out. And then your hatch button is right there. I accidentally pushed it, but there we go. We get the hatch open. This does not look to be a programmable hatch like GM puts in their other vehicles, but I'm gonna go ahead and give that a close and move inside. I do have this thing running right now, which is why it's binging at me. But when we move inside, we get 33 inches of curved OLED screen. Very nice, very easy to read. Your controls are over here to show the different gauge designs. So we can have our energy meter. We had our standard gauges. We could do a map. I don't have that on just yet, but it uses Google Maps. And then clean, simple design right there. I like to leave it on gauge or energy. We also have controls over here for your current trip efficiency. You can slide between these, trip one, trip two, and a blank screen right there. So different drive mode buttons right there, and then buttons for your headlights, on, off, parking, all that. So there was a lot to do made of the Chevy Colorado, getting rid of your light controls, but Cadillac did it first. They put it all here, but you can actually access it over here on the screen as well. So again, I had them on for the purposes of showing you what those lights look like, but you can control it right there. So this is all touchscreen, as was the side over there on the left. You can see we've got stuff in here like your dome lights, your one pedal driving, your camera system. So 360 cameras, you can see up in front of you and behind you, all different angles, and Cadillac denotes that right there. But yeah, those are our front wheels, and then that is out the back view right there. So very good camera views in this one as well. Very simple, easy to use. This is the new Cadillac system. I really like that. Steering wheel is nice, is leather wrapped, nicely padded, lots of buttons up here. We've got our Super Cruise indicator. We'll talk more about that when we drive. Your drive mode selector is, again, Mercedes style, giving me some Mercedes vibes. You actually had to put your foot on the brake, pull, and either push up or push down. And then there is a button right here on the end for park. All your climate control buttons are right here. Very nice, easy to use. You get a little joystick for all of your vent controls, which are really interesting over here on the passenger side. Really cool look to them. Very mechanical in nature. Your center console is not your traditional center console because there's no traditional things about this vehicle. There's no transmission tunnel or anything like that. So we kind of get this floating design right here. You do get a little storage drawer that pulls out from right here that does have a little rubberized texture. So again, things won't rattle around in there. Down here, we have a USB-C. We've got some padded storage that goes rather far back here. Two cup holders, your controller, if you don't want to smudge up your screen right there, with some quick access buttons and a volume knob, I very much appreciate. If you're not going to have a traditional knob, a little roller wheel like that. Qi wireless charger that does work with my iPhone 14 Pro Max. And much like the Cadillac Escalade that we had, it's vertical, out of the way. I really like it. There's another USB-C here for, I guess, your passenger if you want it. The center console is a little on the small side. Again, another USB-C and a cigarette style lighter in there. It is lined with felt. The glove box is also nice, and it is controlled from here. You have to release it from here. I actually can't get it open. They must have me in valet mode. So no big complaints there, but yeah, just a little note. A rear view mirror is actually a camera. If we flip it this way, the camera is mounted back on the back of the vehicle. And then looking up above me, I have one massive glass roof, very much a luxury feature right there, letting in a lot of light on this. What could be a very dark interior, but We'll show you at 5'10". I'm very comfortable in here. I can find the perfect driving position. I already showed you two-person memory seats. Plenty of headroom, plenty of legroom, just the right distance from the tilt and telescoping steering wheel. So I really like the front seats, but let's move now and check out the back seats. Before we hop in the back seat, I did want to show you a couple little hidden Easter eggs in this or different things. So old school Cadillac script here with the outline or the profile of the LYRIQ here on the door sills. But I really like an homage to the original Cadillac logo. Again, I drove a 91 growing up with the ducks on the logo. And I remember the Cadillac Catera commercials with the ducks. So the ducks made an appearance here on the side of the dash as well. All right, so like I showed you earlier, you push the button there, the little leg kicks it out. You grab the back of the door and you pull it open. And here we can see three across seating, but a unique seat design. The center seat is actually inset just a little bit to help with headroom. Let's actually get in behind myself at 5'10", close the door. Oh yeah, plenty of leg room behind myself. And there is even a cutout here. I don't know if you can see just how drastic that cutout is on the back of the seat for added knee room. And we've got a pocket on the back of the door or back of the seat. But oh yeah, I could get very comfortable. Plenty of room underneath the seat as well. I can stretch out and really get comfortable back here and make myself have a very luxurious ride. We do have window or door lock and unlock and your window control right here on the door as well. You do get more of that wood pattern, wood with patterns here on the side, your AKG sound system right there, metal latch for opening and closing the door, more stitching back here. Very nice. You are not a second class citizen back here in the back. We get two air vents on the back of the center console, a little bit of storage right there, two USB-C ports and a household style plug right there. And then for child seats, you get this hard plastic cover that stays connected so you don't lose it. You can flip it up and out of the way and have easy access to your lower latches. The backs of the seats actually have latches all the way across. But here on the outboard seat, I've got a nice recline. I feel very comfortable. My head is touching right here, thanks to the roller on this panoramic glass roof. But if I scoot down just a little, which I can do because I've got tons of leg room, I can get very comfortable back here. I could take a nap, no problem. And we'll talk about it on the drive, just how smooth this thing is, but it is a very comfortable vehicle. Moving here to the center, the floor is completely flat because of the Ultium platform and all the batteries being underneath me. So I've got plenty of foot room without having to like straddle any tunnel or anything here in the middle. And I can sit comfortably, although let's see if I can get a good angle. My knees are up a little bit higher because I'm sitting a little bit lower. The seat itself is a little bit lower. It's a little bit more firm. It's not as comfortable as the outside, but I'm also sitting a little more upright, so I'm not hitting my head. So three could ride across back here, absolutely no problem. It would be a little tight of a squeeze, but I would say your taller people would probably, taller torso people would want to ride here and everybody else on the outsides. But yeah, moving back here, very comfortable, very cushiony, lots of cushion to these seats. They are very comfortable. Makes the center seat just a little disappointing. We do have cup holders here in the doors, as well as a full down center console or center armrest with two cup holders. And it does stay parallel to the seat bottom, so you get a nice armrest there. That's enough from a quick tour of it. Let's actually get out and see how this thing drives. All right, getting in the Cadillac LYRIQ, getting ready to drive. Very easy, like I said, very reminiscent of the Mercedes products that I've been in lately, the EQS vehicles. Very easy to get to learn. I do have the one pedal driving on currently through the screen, like I showed you earlier. And you also get this paddle on the back of the steering wheel that you can access it on demand, make for a really quick regen right there. Does a pretty good job of stopping you very quickly just using your left hand, but we're gonna get this thing out on the road. Got a little bit of stretch of road right here. Let's see what this thing does. 300 plus horsepower. Okay, yes, woo! It's quick. like you would expect an electric vehicle to be. Again, very reminiscent of both the EQS SUV and the Mustang Mach-E. I hate to keep bringing those two up, but those are the two that really resonate most true in my memory of what this is like to drive. So if you've test driven either of those, that's a lot of what this is like. This is even very similar in size to that Mustang Mach-E. And then when you need the power, oh, I love it. Very similar in size to that Mustang Mach-E, very similar in driving dynamics and behavior because of the size, because they're both electric drives. I'll bring up that Mercedes again because I've long held that electric vehicles make perfect luxury vehicles. They're quiet, they're smooth, their power delivery is effortless and linear, and just everything about it makes it very luxurious. That's no different here in this 2023 Cadillac LYRIQ. Thanks to the Ultium platform sitting down below me, it is actually like a skateboard underneath me. That's all the battery packs. So this thing is actually quite heavy, but all the weight is down low. So when it comes to performance and handling of this thing, it does a pretty good job because, again, my center of gravity is down low. Don't have to worry about tipping and rollover. Very similar to the Mustang Mach-E that we tested, and just a very nice, comfortable driving behavior. The ride on this is quiet. Those Michelin Primacy Tour tires, there's enough sidewall on them that there's enough cushion when I'm driving. Like, I've got no complaints about the overall driving, riding behavior of this vehicle as you set off down the road. It is very comfortable, and if you're used to one-pedal driving, the one-pedal driving in this does a really good job. Again, that pedal or paddle is there for a little extra regen, and then to turn it off, there is a little quick access button right here that you can get to your screen. There's your glove box release, your camera button. Anything that you would need on a quick access is right there. It's got a light and a door as your indicator of, hey, these are things you'll probably need the most. Really like the Qi wireless charger being right here. I like the connection between my phone and the vehicle. I love the Google infotainment on this. I love that Cadillac has switched to that. Everything I've tested it in has worked very well, very seamlessly. So very much a fan of that. The screens are very easy to read and customize and make just like I want them. Everything about this is very nice, very simple, very easy, very elegant. I'm not going to get a whole lot of time in the behind the wheel of this one because it was loaned to me by our friends at Wagner Cadillac. But if you want to see more driving impressions of this, you want to see Holly's driving impressions, what it's like putting Tucker's child seat in the back, all the stuff that we normally do, as well as a more thorough performance test, be sure to comment down below. Let Cadillac know to send us one of these for a week's worth of testing, because I've just scratched the surface on this one. We've barely dug into the screens. There's a leather-wrapped handle right there on the A-pillar for the passenger. There's a lot to get familiarized and customized here in this vehicle, and this quick little loan from the dealer is not enough to truly get to know the character of it. But I can tell you from my short time in here, everything I have found, everything I've touched, experienced in this, I've liked. It is a very premium vehicle. And if this is the future of the Cadillac brand, they've got a strong future ahead of them. I just hope to see some more V8 powered Escalades now that General Motors is committed to a new generation of their small block V8. We'll see how that goes. Long story short, this vehicle is good. It's very good. It's very comfortable. It is very easy to drive. It is very luxurious. There's a lot to like about this Cadillac LYRIQ, and I hope to get to spend just a little bit more time in one very soon. If you want to see more from us, be sure and follow us on all social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, YouTube. All the things are at GT Garage Talk, or you can just head on over to gtgaragetalk.com. You can hit all the buttons down below, like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, all those things to let the algorithm know to show you more content from us, because we've got more stuff coming very soon, including some more driving events of some very hot, very new products from different brands that you really won't want to miss if you like this Cadillac LYRIQ. But as for me, behind the wheel of the 2023 Cadillac LYRIQ Debut Edition, thanks to my friends at Wagner Cadillac. Until next time, gearheads. Bye.